All right, shalom, shalom. First and foremost, we want to give all praises, honor, and glory to
Yahweh,
Bashem, Yahushua, Bashem, Rakakadash. And that's the true Hebrew names of the Heavenly Father, in the name of His only begotten Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit, in the Lashwan Kadash, the Paleo Hebrew, the Holy Tongue. Yahweh is who the world ignorantly calls the Most High God or Heavenly Father. And Yahweh means He is to be, He exists. Bahashim means in the name. Yahweh Shai is who the world ignorantly calls Jesus Christ. And Yahweh Shai means He is the Savior, He is the Deliverer. Bahashim in the name. Rakakadash is the Holy Spirit. We want to give a double honors to our apostles and elders of Great Millstone who rule well and taught us this truth. And peace and salutations to the Akim, to the brothers that may be tuning in, that studying and pushing this word. And shalom to the Akim, wa athwats, that may be listening, tuning and studying under the vibration of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. We two brothers out of the GMS Boston camp. I'm the brother Tazawar. And we back here with another lesson, man, through the Spirit. You know, hey, we're just here to give warning. You know, we're not here to sugarcoat anything, to trim us our ways, to seek love. We're supposed to give warning to the house of Israel from the Lord. You know, He put His words in our mouths, and we're supposed to prophesy, you know, prophesy the downfall of America, the downfall of Esau, Edom, the coming wars and rumors of wars, which is World War III, which is coming to end all wars, the plagues that the Lord's going to send, you know, the famine, death, destruction. You know, judgment's is drawing nigh, and we're here to be the mouthpiece of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai and give warning to the house of Israel, which is you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. You guys need to repent because you're God's chosen people. You know, you need to put away the things that you were taught from this world, the wicked lifestyle that Esau, Edom, the so-called white man, has endorsed and pushed you as a nation, and repent and seek Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. You know, it says the days that are coming are days of trouble, the days of stress, the days of anguish, you know, evil times, but which is bad times are coming, and we're here to give warning. We are the watchmen that the Lord has set up, and through the Spirit, you know, we're here to give that warning. So we have 2nd Ezra, the 15th chapter. You want to start it out, bro?
2nd Ezra 15, verse 1.
That's right.
And it reads, "Behold, speak thou in the ears of my people the words of prophecy, who shall put in thy mouth, save the Lord."
Erkan, this is a commandment from the Heavenly Father. Once you hear this word, you know, and you're set up to be a prophet, you're supposed to go out on the highways and hedges and prophesy. And also, you know, go on, do lessons amongst the Akim, and keep that spirit, that testimony of Yahweh Shai, which is the spirit of prophecy, pushing. Keep that vibration being pushed out, because the Lord's putting His word, His spirit in our mouths to speak, man. And it's to His people. That's a possessive pronoun. It says my people, which is the Lord's people. Again, you Israelites need to take heed, you know, and this is our job to give you warning from Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai.
It says, "Behold, speak thou in the ears of my people the words of prophecy, we shall put in thy mouth, save the Lord," mm-hmm, "and cause them to be written in the paper, for they are faithful and true."
That's right. And this is why we use the Bible. You know, they're written in paper, these scrolls, you know, they're from the scriptures. You know, this is our foundation. This is not of our own thoughts or vain opinions. We come strictly from through the spirit and power of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, which is these scriptures, man.
Come on. It says, "Fear not the imagination against thee, and let not the incredulity of them trouble thee that speak against thee, for all the unfaithful shall die in the unfaithfulness."
Yes, because the things that we're here doing and we're prophesying is going to cause a bunch of non-believers, naysayers, those that ridicule us or think that we're quote-unquote conspiracy theorists or troublemakers or extremists. We're not supposed to let their incredulity trouble us. We got to keep on pushing this word because we have a job to do. And ultimately, there's a light at the end of the road, at the tunnel, man. There's a compensation for the job that we're doing. Mm-hmm. And we're praying that ultimately, when all hell breaks loose, when the Lord bring these plagues, that the Lord's going to have a hedge around us and protect us and deliver us from these plagues that are bound to come, huh?
There is a recompense, pretty much, what is it? There is a compensation.
Yeah, there's a payment.
For the true believer of Yahweh Hashem Yashar, you know.
That's right. And he read, for all the unfaithful shall die in their unfaithfulness. Mm-hmm. Those that don't think, you know, that the Lord is coming, or you know, they, those that believe that, you know, we're conspiracy theorists, or they say not in this lifetime, those that don't trust in our words and think that we're or a hate group, or we're twisting up the Bible, or we misconstrue. Mm-hmm. Those that are unfaithful are gonna die in their unfaithfulness, because the Lord's gonna bring these plagues, as the brother's gonna read.
Yeah, that's a reward. There's a reward for the believer of Yahweh Hashem Yashar. That was the word I was looking for.
That's right.
It says, verse five. Behold, saith the Lord, I will bring plagues upon the world, discord, famine, death, and destruction, for wickedness had exceedingly polluted the whole earth, and the hurtful works are fulfilled.
And this is the point. The Lord's going to bring plagues upon the world, the sword, famine, death, and destruction. And we're here to give warning that, hey, it's time for those believers that have faith in the Lord to be circumspect and be diligent and seek on the Lord while he may be found, because the times of trouble are ahead, man. Esau, Edom, which is the so-called white race, are going to come down with, through their military. You know, they're going to come down with that great wrath, with that sword, with the destruction. You know, it's Jacob's trouble. And we're here to give you a warning to get right and repent. Because this could be our last... it could be a last summer of comfortability, you know, they say. You know, people right now are in that spirit as, okay, jobs and businesses are starting to open up, no more wearing the mask. So people are in that jubilant spirit, like things is going back to normal. But we know, according to the scriptures, that Babylon the Great, a.k.a. America, can't be healed. So, you know, you don't want to fall victim to the snares or to the traps. Or just being comfortable, you know.
That's right. Come. Comfortability kills, man. When comfortable, right. That's when the Lord visits you, you know. And that security, thou shalt be destroyed.
That's right. I got one real quick. 1 Thessalonians 5:2. For yourselves know perfectly that the day of the Lord so cometh as a thief in the night. For when they shall say peace and safety, then sudden destruction come up upon them as travail upon a woman with child, and they shall not escape. But ye, brethren, are not in darkness, that day should overtake you as a thief. Ye are all the children of the light and the children of the day. We are not of the night nor of darkness. Yeah. Therefore, let us not sleep as do others, but let us watch and be sober.
Yeah, because like when you're comfortable, that's when you take to it. That's when you tend to relax. You know, I'm saying, take your time. You take everything is gonna be good. You take you have it all figured out, and that's when the Lord Yahweh shall visit you, man.
That's right.
You know, but says, but ye brethren are not in darkness. That's personal. The mm-hmm. brethren that the scripture is referring to is the house of David. Those mm-hmm. that's watching, those that know what time they are day in, those that measuring the time diligently in itself, man.
That's right.
You know, we are not in darkness. But ye brethren are not in darkness, that that day shall overtake you as a thief. Because when a thief comes and break into your house, he always comes when you least expecting it. You know, when you're comfortable, when you're sleeping. And that's exactly how the day of Yahweh Hashem Yashar is comparing to. Yahweh Yashar gonna come as a thief to the vast majority of your people, because mm-hmm. the vast majority of your people, you are not paying attention.
That's right.
You are not measuring the time diligently. You are caught up in the world. So when that day comes, you're not gonna know what to do. You're gonna be running around like a chicken with your head cut off. You're not gonna know what to do, you know.
Yeah, they're gonna fill them plagues as the Lord is gonna bring, as we read. You know, you're gonna get overtaken as a thief. You know, you're gonna feel it, death by pain. You know, when all these plagues come upon the earth, and you don't have the hedge of Yahweh Hashem Yahushai, hey, and this is for you Israelites, that you're gonna be fulfilling the role of 2/3. And we pray that the Lord finds us worthy for salvation. We pray that we're part of that hopeful elect. You know, because the days of evil is on the horizon. The day of draweth nigh. You know, and 2/3 of our people have to be destroyed because it's prophecy being fulfilled. And this is why our job is to prophesy, to give warning, to wipe the blood off our hands, as according to Ezekiel, the 3rd chapter, you know. And as we read, those that don't believe or think that we're conspiracy theorists or so on and so forth, there's most likely that you're not part of the elect, you know. But the days of evil are soon to come. And we know that a major prophecy before the the chariots arrive, and before them the ICBM missiles that shot through these armies here to America, before that is established, we know that the MOTB, you know, the RFID microchip, which is the mark of the beast that the Bible speaks of, has to be implemented. And that's a form of Esau coming down with that great sword. You know, there's going to be a time when you're going to realize that the so-called white man is really the devil. He's going to show his horns in a metaphoric type of way, you know.
Verse 5 says, ye are all the children of light. You know, light means prophecy. Light means lights, synonymous wisdom, understanding, right? So we know what's pretty much separate us from the vast majority of your people, because we have the light. We know what's to take place in the new future. You know, we know the end. We know the end of the movie, because mm-hmm. the Lord says, he declared the end for the beginning. So that's exactly why we're not gonna be cut off guard when all hell breaks loose, because we are anticipating the coming of Yahweh Hashem Shai. We are pretty much waiting for it, you know.
That's right.
That's exactly what we're hasting for, you know.
The only way you could be in the light is when you have to repent and have faith and fear Yahweh Hashem Shai. He's the only one that can give you that light, give you that hedge, give you that knowledge, wisdom, and understanding. As according to Proverbs 1:7, fear in the Lord is the beginning of knowledge and wisdom. Mm-hmm. You know, I got Ephesians 5:14. Wherefore he said, awake thou that sleepest, and arise from the dead, and Yahweh Shai shall give thee light. See then that you walk circumspectly, not as fools, but as wise, redeeming the time, because the days are evil. And that's what we're here to warn you. The days that are coming are bad times. Evil is coming. And, you know, there's plenty of scriptures that give descriptions of the day of the Lord. Like Zephaniah 1:14, he says, what, a day of distress, a day of anguish, dark clouds and thick darkness. You know, so this is what's coming, man. And this is why you got to be circumspect, meaning walk and know your surroundings. You know, keep your head on a swivel, because the days are evil. You know, come.
Matter of fact, I got one real quick. On 2 Chronicles 36:15. Let's get that real quick. 2 Chronicles.
I'll get it for you. You can read it. Mm-hmm. I mean, you can break it down. Mm-hmm. 2 Chronicles 36:15. Mm-hmm. And the Lord Yahweh.
So verse 14. All
right. Mm-hmm. 2 Chronicles 36:14. Mm-hmm. Moreover, all the chief of the priests and the people transgressed very much after all the abominations of the heathen, and mm-hmm. polluted the house of the Lord, which he had hallowed in Jerusalem.
Yeah, because like your people, pretty much they are following the footstep of Esau. They are polluted, and that's exactly what you said. 2/3 of our people, they gotta go, because they polluted to a point that they don't want to do nothing with Yahweh Hashem Shai. And guess what? If you don't choose Yahweh Hashem Shai, by default you are pretty much with Esau. So by you pretty much in a league with Esau, the Lord had to cut you off, man.
That's right.
You know, you are unfit to be his people. And that's exactly why there's a clear difference between the Israel of the Most High and the house of Israel.
Yeah. You know? That's right. Verse 15, and the Lord, the power of their fathers, sent to them by his messengers, rising up betimes and sending, because he had compassion on his people and on his dwelling place.
Yeah, diligently. We pretty much go out there on the weekend with the lesson on the weekdays, diligently, bedtime, meaning diligently. We give you the warning. Mm-hmm. We're giving you the warning. We try to wash your blood off our hands.
That's right.
When all her blood close, we're not gonna be responsible for your death, because we told you.
That's right. And when we read, because he had compassion on his people, hey, the Lord has set a purpose for the prophets to bring those sinners and, you know, back to repentance. The Lord is giving our people a chance for repentance. That's showing compassion and mercy.
Mm-hmm.
You know, but there's a group of people from the line of Israel that just are hard-headed, stiff-necked, rebellious people. You know, they don't want to follow the way of righteousness. They're too comfortable. They have that security and wickedness under Esau, Edom, bro.
Huh?
Verse 16, but they mocked the messengers of the Most High and despised his words and misused his prophets, until the wrath of the Lord arose against his people till there was no remedy.
Yeah, they mocked the messenger of Yahweh Hashem Shai and despised his words, man. So mm-hmm. the vast majority of our people, they despise this word, man. They don't want nothing to do with this word. You know, they have loaded my law while they have yet labored it.
Mm-hmm.
It's like the same was snoot after death by pain. So the vast majority of you so-called black Hispanics and Americans, you're gonna know it when I have a close, man. You're gonna know that this man that was amongst you, you know, they were the prophets, man.
That's right.
It's going to be too late, man.
That's right. As it says in Ezekiel 33, verse 33. And ultimately, this is nothing personal. You don't hate us. Because we read in the beginning, we started off that the Lord is going to put his words in our mouths. So we're speaking the message of Yahweh Shem HaRashai. So you don't really hate the prophets. You hate the Lord. You hate the scriptures. You hate the way of righteousness. And this is why when that wrath of the Lord comes and you don't have that hedge, you are going to feel it by death by pain, as the brother quoted from 2nd Ezra, the 9th chapter. Mm-hmm. You know, and this is what our job is to do, constantly prophesy, prophesy the downfall of great kingdoms, of nations, of wars, and of evil, and of pestilence, you know, and those that hear it, that are Israelites, the elect, are going to come back and repent. You know, they're going to be marked for, like Ezekiel 9 and 4, exemption from judgment. Mm-hmm. But those that don't take heed, hey, they're marked for death. That's right. You know? Okay. And like the brother quoted, he mentioned, there's going to be a time and moment and when all hell breaks loose, and you're going to wish that you took heed once you heard the prophets and heard this warning. Yeah. And that's going to lead to Ezekiel, Ezekiel 33 and 33. Oh, yeah. But yeah, you are 9 and 4, true. Yeah. Come on, I'll get it real quick. Ezekiel 33, verse 33. And when this come to pass, lo, it will come. Then shall they know that a prophet had been among them.
Yeah, because just like in the days of Noah, right? Noah was preaching for 120 years, warning the people. They mocked Noah. They refused to take heed. Yep. And guess what? Eventually, they found out that Noah was a prophet. Right?
Yeah.
When the flood came and they had nowhere to go, that's when they realized that Noah was the prophet.
Yeah, they met their death.
No.
You know, they were banging on the ark, trying to beg Noah to open up the ark. But ultimately, it was the Spirit of the Lord that kept that ark closed.
Mm-hmm.
You know? And it's heavy, because the same way Noah was prophesying, the prophets now are prophesying for many years.
Mm-hmm.
And this death is going to be the second death, which is fire.
Mm-hmm.
You know? And there's going to be no way to escape. And that door is ultimately through the chariots, man.
Yeah.
That ark is going to be through a chariot. And there's only a selected few, which is the remnant, the elect, that's going to be delivered, you know?
Yeah, because Yahushua says, as in the days of Noah,
mm-hmm.
where so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be.
That's
just
right.
Like back in the day when Noah was prophesying, they mocked him. They refused to take heed. You know what I'm saying? That's the same thing that's happening today.
That's
you
right.
Know? And so the Lord closed the door of the ark, and the people pretty much, they have no access to go into it. And guess what? They were destroyed.
That's
the
right.
Same things can happen in a lifetime, man.
That's right.
The scripture says, for whatsoever things were written aforetime,
were written for our learning.
You know?
And we know there's nothing new under the sun. This is history, biblical history, that's repeating itself.
Mm-hmm.
But this time it's not going to be by water or flood in the earth. It's going to be by fire.
Mm-hmm.
There's going to be a lake of fire that's hitting America, and there's going to be war and destruction in other places of the eastern region. But it's ultimately prophesied that America, aka Babylon the Great, is going to be utterly destroyed off the face of the earth. It's going to be a lake of fire, as John the Revelator prophesied and had a vision of, you know?
Yeah, and also the salvation going to be to the chariots, man.
That's right.
You're going to be beamer up there, man. You know,
that's right.
The scripture says, only thine eyes shall thou behold and see the reward of the wicked.
That's
so
right.
We're going to be one of those men. We're going to be way up there from the atmosphere,
mm-hmm.
looking at destruction.
Yep.
You know?
Yeah, the elect are going to have an aerial view.
Mm-hmm.
You know, when I read that, you know, John had that vision and he saw a lake of fire, it was like he was had a vision that he was in a chariot looking
mm-hmm.
down on the earth.
Mm-hmm.
And the elect, and again, like the brother, like we pray that we're part of that hopeful elect, we're gonna have that skybox view, kind of, if you go to a sporting event and you get the skybox, you got that whole aerial view, see the whole game. Well, in this time, we pray that we're going to be in them chariots, seeing that America being utterly destroyed. You're going to see a lake of fire, just like John the Revelator. You know?
That's right.
Hey, and this is the warning, man. Whether you believe it or not, you know, all hell's going to break loose. You know, this, you know, with the jab that Esau's trying to make mandatory. You know, the MOTB, you know, the RFID chip got to be made mandatory. You know, FEMA camps, martial law, you know, Jacob's trouble. It's over the horizon. And ultimately, them thermonuclear missiles is the icing of the cake, the blowing of the candle, let's say, you know. And this is what's coming to America. And we're here to give warning to our nation to repent. Repent and seek the Lord while he may be found. Because if you don't, hey, he's going to overtake you as a thief in the night, man.
Oh, come on. Yeah. Hey, man, that was a lesson, man. Yeah. We hope this was edifying, you know, because everything we do is for edification's sake, you know?
That's right.
So we want to give all praises and honor and glorification due to
Yahweh, Bashem, Yahusha, Bashem, Rakakadash.
Double honor to our elders, apostles, Grand Master, James, whole world, and on peace and blessings to the hopefully Lekakiam out there pushing this gospel, this doctrine of Yahweh, Bashem, Shai, and righteousness, and sincerity, and truth. Until next time, Shalom.
Shalom.